Our cities are choking and the air that you're breathing is rapidly going from bad to worse. While Delhi NCR is preparing to combat pollution with a ban on cracker sales and other precautionary measures, Mumbai and Chennai also inch towards poor air quality zone. A quiet and promising evening gave way to thick haze and noise as Delhi celebrated Diwali, dashing the hopes of a cracker-free festivities following a Supreme Court ban on the sale of firecrackers in the NCR. The online indicators of the pollution monitoring stations in the city glowed red, indicating a very poor air quality. The pollutants had violated the corresponding 24-hour safe level by almost up to 10 times the normal levels. Milan now joins me on the phone line for more details. Milan, how is the air quality that we are looking today, at least in the Delhi NCR area, a day after Diwali?
Definitely, day after Diwali, the clear skies have given way to haze as a lot of cracker bursting happened yesterday around Delhi NCR. But what we know is the air quality index measure says that compared to last year, the level of air quality index is lower and continues to remain at a very poor level. Last year during Diwali, it was at a severe level of 402 on Diwali Eve, which escalated to 431. But this time it has remained at 320 levels, which is a significant decrease from the last year. Also, the meteorological conditions arising in the Delhi NCR region right now have helped to keep the particulate matter 2.5 to a minimum this year. And still, however, the air quality remains to be under very poor conditions, and prolonged exposure to this kind of air could definitely result in health hazards, Apurva. Back to you.
Milan, more importantly, has the Supreme Court ban on the sale of firecrackers percolated down to an effective way in order to remove the pollution levels in Delhi NCR? Well, staying with news, as far as the air quality index is concerned, in other major cities as well, Mumbai woke up to a smoggy morning with air quality index reaching an hazardous level of 341 at 6 a.m. Safa, meanwhile, has warned that the situation is likely to worsen post-Diwali. This even though Diwali this year has been less noisy in the cities and the suburb. The city overall recorded an air quality index between 240 and 270 on October 20th. The officials attributed the pollution level to the pollution caused due to bursting of crackers. Richa now joins me on the phone line with more details. Richa, we saw the condition of the cities, the mega cities. We saw how things are in Delhi. What is the situation on ground in Mumbai? Are the Mumbaikars waking up to a very smoggy morning after Diwali?
Also, Mumbai woke up to a very smoggy morning a day after the Diwali festivities were on, and the authorities are stating the reason for this being the bursting of the crackers that happened on Thursday throughout the day and into the night. And it did reach hazardous level till 6 a.m. in the morning. That's what has been recorded so far. And the actual figure that they have stated in this whole matter is that at the U.S. consulate, it reached a level of 341 by 6 a.m. in the morning. And although the skies and the pollution level is residing, but at the same time, they have warned that post-Diwali festivities, it might even increase further.
In Chennai, the situation has also worsened. The air quality index reached a hazardous level at 6 a.m. in the morning today. Meanwhile, at IIT Chennai, the AQI reached an unhealthy level of 218. The Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board has already issued a warning to restrict bursting of crackers to the maximum extent possible following a weather forecast that the city may witness smog during and, in fact, build up post-Diwali. The board has also requested residents to take a sympathetic view of the health impacts of bursting firecrackers and have on pets and stray animals.